brought me this far, so why would I question you now? My faith for me in college kind of came to the conclusion I had the opportunity to study theology and philosophy, and came convinced that what our church has to tell us about ourselves and about God and about our world was certainly worth listening to. And so I became a theology teacher and a baseball coach and taught here at Notre Dame for 4 years, and then was able to become the principal. And for me in my life, my faith plays a central role in who I am and what I do, and trying to be focused on prayer each day to have God guide me in the ways that He wants me to act and the decisions that I make. And as I raise my family and my marriage, and just to keep trying to grow closer to Him, because we all need His help every day in what we do, and to be a part of our community here at Notre Dame to hopefully help all of you grow in your faith has been a big part of my life. So, that's
it. My faith is important to me on a daily basis, especially teaching in a Catholic school. It gives me the experience of praying with my students before every class period and introducing things about Catholicism into lessons that I wouldn't normally get to do if I was at another school. I also really enjoy praying with my players before practices and before matches, because it incorporates God not only into our everyday life but into our sporting life, which sometimes we don't think a lot about. And it means a lot to me to be able to relay my faith to my players and show that God is present all the time, everywhere. All we need to do is ask Him for help.
My name is Danny Burke, and this is my 7th year at Notre Dame, teaching and also coaching soccer and wrestling. I was lucky enough to be a graduate of Peoria Notre Dame High School in 2002, and ever since I was a kid, I've been blessed that I had a strong desire to chip with God and to continue to search for a better relationship and a better understanding of my faith. You know, one of the most trying or challenging time periods of my life was when I was in college and competing as a collegiate athlete. I kind of started to fall into the trap of feeling a lot of pressure to win, instead of going out and having fun and doing it for all the reasons that I had started to do it. I was feeling pressure and having that fear of failure, or fear of letting people down. And it was during that time period where I really started to develop a better understanding and a better perspective of my relationship with God, where having the opportunity to compete was a blessing. And it was more of, you know, looking at it instead of going out and being afraid of failure and feeling as if I had to win or feeling pressure to win. I went out there and I felt more of an opportunity to glorify God and to glorify the gifts and talents that He had given me. And during that time period, I really grew in my relationship with God, and that's something that I've really carried with me ever since then, just that understanding that every day we're given a great opportunity to grow and to use our gifts and talents, you know, to help everybody else out. And I think that's something that sometimes we tend to take for granted, but at the same time, you know, it's something that it restarts every day, and we can continue to develop a better understanding of that.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Buckles, and I just have a story of a way that faith has positively impacted my life. As many of you know, I studied abroad in Mexico for 6 months, and I don't like traveling, and I really like to be at home, so that was a really scary experience for me at first. And when I first got there, I didn't know anybody. I just felt so alone. I've never felt so lonely in my whole life. And so I couldn't even talk to my parents because we didn't have internet or anything, and you can't use the phones to call the US there. So one day my little brother, my little host brother, Andres, told me, "Well, if you can't call your real mom, why don't you call our mom, Mother Mary?" And I was like, "Okay, that's fine." So I started praying to Mary and I asked her to take care of me. And the day after I did that, I went to school and I made a friend. And guess what her name was? Maria. Then in my next class, somebody else started to talk to me, and her name was Mariana. Same thing in the next class. That day, I met a girl, and her name was Marty Carmen. And by the end of the day, I had made 5 new friends, and all of their names had something to do with Mary. Well, that day after church, after school, we were driving home. My host mom said, "Why don't we go to church? You know, we can pray, and maybe you'll feel better then too." So we went, and I asked, "What's the name of this church?" And of course, she said, "Oh, this is the parish of Our Lady." So after that, and I've really felt taken care of by our mother, and it was just something so tangible that I saw, and I'm still friends with these girls today. So that's one way that Our Lady has taken care of me in my life.
Hey everybody, my name is Tim Speck, and I'm the Dean of Students over at Notre Dame High School, and my assignment was to talk to you about my faith. What I'd say over the last couple years, I've really tried to make my faith and my relationship with God kind of the foundation of my life. I think as you guys are starting to realize as you get older, life doesn't necessarily go the way that you planned it or the way that you expect it to go. And through those tough times, the power of prayer and having a relationship with God can really get you through those moments. In my family, we've gone through some things over the last couple years that have been difficult. And I've seen firsthand how the power of prayer can make a difference in getting through those tough times. So it's definitely something that I've incorporated into my daily life, whether it's trying to go to morning mass during the week or it's trying to fit in a rosary sometime during the day. I think that's made a big difference in my life and allowing myself to maintain perspective. I think sometimes we get too caught up in the day-to-day living of things and emotions and what other people do, and I think it's having a relationship with God and relying on prayer can allow you to maintain that perspective of what's important, and it makes day-to-day living a lot easier. So that's just a minute or so on my faith, and I hope that helps you out as you guys go out into the world on your own. And foster your own relationships with God. So take care, everybody, and I'll talk to you.
My faith has really been an important part of my life because with my relationship with Christ, the way I go into every day has changed. I realize that every moment is important, every conversation, every experience. I'm no longer just going into my day like a habit or a routine. I realize that I go into my day expecting that Christ will show up and that hopefully I will be able to show Christ's face through my daily encounters. Whether this is a conversation or just being a listening ear, or even if it's just getting the work done that I need to get done, I realize that it's done for a greater good. And this is the way I've encountered Christ most easily is through the face of other people who I see are just genuinely being themselves, that are being joyful, I see them in their selfless and their kind activities, and I'm able to recognize Christ, and I realize that they're living for something more, for something extraordinary, and that's kind of shaped the way that I want my life to be as well.
Okay, well, my faith has impacted me in lots of ways. I've been a Catholic and a Christian for 4 years this Easter. I got baptized and confirmed in 2010, and a lot of what brought me to the church was Peoria Notre Dame because I started working here as an assistant coach, and I got to be involved in Mass and with some of the other faith-based things that we do, and then I realized it was a really good thing. So after I became a Christian, faith changed me in lots of ways. First, it taught me that life isn't all about me. Life is about others more than it's about me, and it's also taught me that God's will is really what makes me whole and what makes me a full person. And I think God's will for me is to be the best version of me that I can be through following his guidelines and the things he wants me to do.